In this video, we'll look at the ideal gas law. We'll use the ideal gas law to calculate pressure, volume, number of moles, and temperature. The ideal gas law, PV equals nRT, is a result of combining Boyle's law, Charles' law, and Avogadro's law. When these laws were combined, it came up with the ideal gas law, PV equals nRT. P is pressure of the gas in atmospheres. Volume, V is volume of the gas in liters. N is for the number of moles of the gas in moles. T is for temperature of gas in Kelvin. And R is the ideal gas constant. And for the calculations we'll be doing most often, that is 0.082057 liters atmospheres divided by moles Kelvin. Now, the ideal gas law is not because it's an ideal law, but because it works when we consider an ideal gas. An ideal gas has two main components. All collisions between atoms or molecule in the gas are perfectly elastic, and no intermolecular attractive forces. The ideal gas assumption applies most often when we have gases that do not have charges or partial charges, so therefore they behave elastically. And gases often have very, very low intermolecular attractive forces because there's such a great distance between them. If either of these assumptions is incorrect, then we cannot use the ideal gas law. For most gases, the ideal gas law works just fine. Let's work a couple of problems. What is the volume of 1 mole of gas at STP? If we look at this problem, we'll see that we're most likely going to be using the ideal gas law, PV equals nRT. Therefore, we can dissect the question by looking at what's going on. What is the volume? If we draw out PV equals nRT, from that first part of the question, we know that we're going to be looking for our volume. We also know that we already know the number of moles, 1.00 moles for N, and of course we know R because R is our constant. It said at STP. Well, what is STP? STP is standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature and pressure is 0 degrees Celsius or 273 degrees Kelvin and 1 atmosphere. So therefore, since we know it's at STP, we can put in for pressure 1 atmosphere and for temperature 273 Kelvin because we know R is in Kelvin. Once we have this, then we just need to restructure PV equals nRT to calculate for volume. So if we look at PV equals nRT, we want to get volume by itself, so therefore we're going to divide through by P. We do that and we cancel out our P's, leaving volume by itself, so therefore volume is going to equal nRT over P. Now that we have the formula, we'll just plug in to this formula and we see that volume equals 1 mole times 0.082057 liters times atmospheres over moles Kelvin times 273 degrees Kelvin over 1 atmosphere. From this, checking our units, we see that moles are going to cancel, Kelvin will cancel, and atmospheres will cancel, which will leave us liters. We do the calculation, and we see that volume equals 22.4 liters. Straightforward, as long as you follow the steps, and make sure you read your question correctly. Let's look at another problem. How many moles of methane, CH4, occupy a 10-liter tank whose pressure is 4.00 atmospheres at 25.0 degrees Celsius? Again, since we're dealing with moles, volumes, atmospheres, and a temperature, we can assume that we're going to use PV equals nRT. Now we have to figure out what each of those values are. So from the problem, we know that we are looking for the number of moles. We know that our pressure is going to be 4.00 atmospheres. We know our volume is 10.0 liters. We know R because R is our constant. And our temperature is going to be 25.0 degrees Celsius. We'll need to convert that into Kelvin, so we'll add 273, so we'll get 298 degrees Kelvin. Again, like we did before, we need to look at our formula, reformulate it to come by moles by itself, so we're going to want to isolate N. If we see, the first thing we're going to do is divide by RT. If we divide by RT, we will cancel out R and T on one side. That's going to give us PV over RT equals N. Now that we have our formula situated, we can put in our values. So here we have 4.0 atmospheres times 10.0 liters over our constant, 0.082057 liters atmospheres per mole Kelvin, multiplied by 298 Kelvin equals the number of moles. Again, check your units. See that atmosphere will cancel, liters cancel, and Kelvin cancel. So therefore, we just plug in our numbers. We're going to do the calculation and end up with 1.63579 moles equal N. But if we look at our values, we need three significant figures. To show that correctly, we need to reformulate this into 1.64 mole. Practice with it and become confident.